In this video, we will explore placing and customizing windows. If we go to the Build drop-down menu at the top of the screen, and then down to the Window Parent tool, you will find all of the Window Child tools, including Window, Bay, Box, and Bow windows, the Pass-Through, and the Niche tools. You will also find these if you look here in your toolbar and find the Window icon. This is the Window Tools Parent tool. When you click on this tool, again, you will find all of the window child tools here in the child tool palette at the left of your screen. I'll click on window to activate the tool. To place a window, you must first build a wall. There is no need to create an opening in the wall. The window tools will do this automatically. When you hover over a wall, you can see the preview of what the window will look like. Click to place the window. Notice that when I move close to the corner, the window will only move to the point where the casing bumps against the adjacent wall. Once you have placed a window, the window tool stays active for you to place another window. To deactivate the window tool, you can click on the Select Objects tool or hit your spacebar. Once you have placed a window, you can move it using the Move Edit Handle. You can also change the width using the Side Edit Handles, or activate one of the side edit handles and use the temporary dimensions to resize it by clicking on the dimension number and typing in the exact length you want. You can also use the temporary dimensions to move the window into place. If I click on the temporary dimension, I can type in the exact distance I want from the end of the wall. Notice that when you click on the inside edge of the window, the temporary dimensions are measuring from the inside of the adjacent wall. If I click on the outside, it is measuring to the outside corner of the connecting walls. You can also change the size of a window by opening the Window Specification dialog. To do this, you will select the window and then click on the Open Object tool in the Edit toolbar that appears at the bottom of the screen. You can also open an Object Specification dialog by double-clicking on the object. Here in the Window Specification dialog, you can see that the window type says Use Default, and you can see in the Preview pane that the window is a double-hung window type. All the settings in this dialog are determined by what is set in the Window Default Settings. I'll close this dialog, and then we'll take a brief look at the default settings for Windows. I'll double-click on the Window Parent tool to open the Window Defaults dialog. Notice that it is almost identical to the individual Window Specification dialog. This is where you would change all of the characteristics of the windows that you want to place in your plan. For instance, the window type here is set as a double-hung window. If I change this to a right sliding window and change the size to a 48-inch by 48-inch window, all the windows that I place from now on in the plan will be 4040 sliding windows. But you will want to note that if you change your window defaults after you've placed some windows in your plan, some of the characteristics of the old windows in the plan will change, some will not. For instance, the first window that is already placed in this plan is a double hung window that is 32 inches by 48 inches. Now that I've changed the size and the type in the default settings, notice that the first window that I placed did change to a sliding window, but the size did not change. The property that changed the type of window is called a dynamic default. It will change the existing windows in the plan. However, size is not a dynamic default. The size of all the existing windows in the plan will not change. To learn more about default settings, you can explore additional online training videos. Now let's take a brief look at some of the settings in the individual windows. I'll open up this Window Specification dialog by double-clicking on the window. Again, you can see the window type is following the default, and the Preview pane is showing a sliding window. You can change each individual window to be whatever type you want: fixed glass, casement, sliding, hopper, etc. You can also change the size of this one window and the height placement in the wall. With the height change, you determine what you want this dimension to reference. You can make it relative to the floor, the finished floor, or relative to absolute. Absolute always refers to the top of the floor platform on floor level 1. On the Options panel, you have corner block options, egress, and tempered glass options. These will only apply when you generate a material list or a window schedule. These changes will not be visible in your plan. The casing on a window is referring to the outer trim piece you see here. You can change the size and depth of the casing trim at the interior side or exterior side. You can also change the molding profile that is used. You can also change the size of the sash. The sash refers to this piece here that holds the glass in place. Once you've customized any of the dynamic default settings in a dialog, you can change it back to follow the defaults by clicking on the white wrench button here at the side. You can also change the size of the frame piece. The frame refers to this piece that surrounds the sash and caps off the jamb, header, and sill framing. You can further customize your window by adding divided lights, changing the window shape, adding an arch, adding window treatments, and changing the way the wall frames around the window. You also have options for different materials applied to the different window components. Another window tool is the bay window. The bay window tool will build in the wall extensions and place windows on each side and center of the bay. To edit the bay window walls, you can double-click on it to open the bay window specification dialog. Here, you can change the walls of the bay by changing the width, depth, or angle of the side walls. You can also change the wall type that it's building. It will automatically use the wall type of the wall that it's placed in, but you can change that for a different look. You can also raise and lower the floor and ceiling heights. But you'll notice that this specification dialog has no window settings. You can edit each window on the sides and in the center by clicking once on the window, which will select the entire bay's structure. Then hit your Tab key to select only the window. Use your Open Object tool at the bottom of your screen to open the window specification dialog. You can also Tab to select a window and delete it if you wish. Once you've placed a bay window, when you build the roof tool will build over it as specified in the Options panel for the roof. The box and bow windows behave very much the same way and have many of the same settings. You also have the pass-through tool that places a framed, cased opening, like a window, without glass. The last tool under the Windows Parent tool is the Niche tool. The niche is an opening in only one side of the wall that leaves the original finish on the back side. The niche specification dialog has many of the same settings a window does, including size, casing, shape, and component materials.